Today's talk focuses on the issue of Fisker and solid-state batteries, as well as is Tesla hoarding. Batteries. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Thanks once again for joining us. If you're new to our channel, please like and subscribe. If you're returning, welcome back. One of my viewers made a request that I consider doing a talk on what's going on with solid-state batteries. I have to admit that I took a quick glance at them maybe every 6 months to see what's going on, but I really haven't been taking it seriously because every time I started reading something, it said in 2026, this or 2022, 25, this or that is going to happen. So I was having a hard time determining, you know, why to put any time into it, but this kind of gave me an opportunity and a good reason to go check it out. So after researching with my PhD buddies, as well as doing some reading, what I learned is that Fisker is going to, in January, announce a new product, and they're also going to be announcing their new car. Their car currently is going to be operating on lithium-ion batteries, and the patents they've got for solid state won't be, they're saying, ready to go until approximately 2023. So this kind of brings up my point about the 2023 issue. I have to admit that part of the reason why I didn't really think a lot about Tesla was when Fisker failed, I thought that perhaps all electric cars were headed down that path. And clearly, my analysis was off, and Tesla has actually done quite well. So I sort of am going to list here on the sheet that you can read while I read some of it. You know, some of the parameters that are associated with solid state. Basically, a solid state, Fisker's claiming it can charge up in a minute. It has maybe twice the range, as well as weighs half as much. So from kind of every form factor metric, it seems to be a better solution than lithium ion. The thing I find interesting is that certainly Fisker is in action, and I want to say they've been a failed company. Toyota is actually active in this space as well. And what I've noticed from them is that they're saying 2022 before it's ready. A few points that I want to cover here, but again, I'll list in, you know, different ways, details I've learned, is that number one, you know, the problem they're having right now is this solution perhaps works for very small devices and really hasn't scaled up to be ready to get all the way to regular batteries in cars yet. So I think that this sounds like great technology, and it sounds like it'll get the job done. I have total confidence in Tesla's research facilities and their ability to bring something forward should it be viable and probably be one of the early purveyors of it. I also think that lithium ion taking a backseat to it, because in general, I expect, you know, within 3 or 4 years for lithium ion to get a charge done in the 10-ish minute zone of a vehicle. And sort of the precursor to that is a 30-minute charge on a 500-mile or 400-mile charge in 30 minutes on the new semi. So I definitely think the charge speed has been made a priority. And there's a bunch of other measures that have been done. One of the highlights that I'll be including sort of at this point in the video is there's an image that I'll put over my shoulder as well as in the video, so that you can take a look at sort of the difference of how the two batteries look. In particular, another form factor I thought that was interesting for the solid state was the fact that they can have thinner membranes between the cells, and I think it increases the amount of density, and it's part of the reason why you can get, you know, sort of less space, maybe twice the battery. So, you know, I think it's a legit product, but even those who are promoting it are years away from having anything ready for autos, and we'll keep you posted on it as it develops. The next thing I wanted to cover is sort of a discussion that's going on regarding Tesla hoarding batteries. So what this is about is the fact that it's been suggested that Tesla, because of its continued use of 1860B batteries that are imported from Japan via Panasonic, that consumption of batteries, in addition to the fact that they're not selling any of their 2170 batteries, means there's kind of a shortage going on. Part of the reason I was looking forward to doing this talk was that sometimes you start collecting little bits of information and it's not enough to put a show on about it, but it sort of ends up being a show later. And in this case, what I've been amazed by is during 2017, every 3 or 4 weeks, a different manufacturer has announced from 5 or 10% of their line to up to 100% of their line by 2021 or 2022 will be electric. And so I think it's great that Tesla has sort of seeded the market to help facilitate this. What I was really shocked is the number of folks that have articulated the fact that they're going to be ready to go in terms of having new products. But the problem that I'm seeing is, where are the batteries coming from? And what I mean by that is that in the case of Tesla, in 2012 or 13, the CTO of Tesla, J.B. Strobel, did some evaluation, and they went around and tried to set up the purchase of the batteries that were going to be used in the Model 3. When they went to all the manufacturers to do that, they found a world during that year. So it then became clear that they were not viable to go in the open market and buy the batteries necessary for the solution that they wanted to do. Hence, the change was made to go ahead and try to build a gigafactory and get it done. And so, basically, Tesla builds a gigafactory, and now we're in an interesting situation because from what I can tell, let's say all of the 20 or so companies that have announced that they want to go electric, get all the batteries they want, I think that it's probably at least 10, if not 20, million cars worth of battery that would be on the streets tomorrow. The problem is, from what I can see in terms of the open market, you know, Tesla's not selling theirs, and Daimler-Benz isn't selling theirs, especially after they bought half of a Korean company to help produce the volume they need to service their cars. So basically, what I'm noticing is that there's probably 20 million a year worth of battery needs or wants by automakers, but the open market only has maybe 1, possibly 2 million cars worth of batteries available. So I expect that this shortage, you know, capacity is being added, but it takes time to build these factories, 2 to 3 years for a large facility, as you've seen with the Tesla build out. So my expectation is that I think the amount of batteries available in the open market will continue to increase probably in that 500,000 to a million batteries a year, heading into the middle, maybe 2025 or so. And so basically, I see the shortage continuing, and it forces manufacturers, not Tesla, to figure out plan B. I think plan B might be, do you only put out very expensive cars so you can limit the number of batteries consumed? Do you, you know, how do you go through the rationing? Do you do possibly a lot of hybrids until you can get enough battery, you know, to do a complete electric? You know, I think there's a bunch of questions there. The part of the discussion, too, is do you follow Tesla and copy the 2170 and build that as a factory? Do you wait until solid state is ready? There's a bunch of questions that I think are open in terms of what's going to occur. And then, you know, I really think that Tesla is sort of the leader of the pack and will make good decisions in terms of what's going forward on this.